Hello everyone, this is Saurabh Kumar and I welcome you all to my video series of CISSP where we are going to talk about, in this video, organizational roles and responsibility. But at the end of this video, I will be also talking about some control framework. So let's first begin with the different roles and responsibility of different job profile. So here I'm going to list some of the job profile and then I'm going to explain each of them one by one. As we all know that a security role is a part of an individual plays in an overall scheme of security implementation and administration within an organization. Security roles are not necessarily prescribed in job description because they are not always distinct or static. But obviously, whenever you are working for a company with any job profile, there are some different criteria which you're supposed to fulfill, which you're supposed to follow. So here are some of the job profiles are such as senior manager, there will be security professional, there will be some who will be working as a data owner, there will be data custodian, there will be user as well as an auditor. So these are some of the job profile and whose responsibility we are going to talk in this particular video. So let me first start with the senior manager. As we all know, when we talk about a senior manager, what does it mean that an organization owner itself is a senior manager? Or maybe something similar to that, like CEO or any other person who are at the top level of management. Their role is assigned to a person who is ultimately responsible for entire security maintained by an organization. They are the one who is controlling everything and who should be most concerned about the protection of its asset, because at the end of the day, what exactly the data is, it is of the owner of the organization, it is of the CEO of the company. So basically they will be more focused about the data protection, but they may not be an IT person. They will be maybe just having a mindset of business. They are good in business management, but not in IT. So they are the final person, they are the last person who take the decision, but there has to be some other person who will be acting as an IT guy in their organization. Let's have a look on more about senior manager. So the senior manager must sign off on all policy issues. Generally, the policy will be created by somebody else, but before it gets implemented, it must be signed off by the senior manager. Another thing is the senior manager is the person who will be held liable for the overall success or failure of a security solution. So, and he will be also responsible for exercising due care and due diligence in establishing security for an organization. So at the end of this video, I am also going to explain what is due care and due diligence is. Meanwhile, what we can talk right now is senior manager is the person actually who will be responsible either something gets successful or either failure also. So at the end, actually all the security professional or data owner or others, they are all working under the senior manager. So these are some of the points when we talk about the senior manager. So let's, in most cases, what we can also see that responsibility is delegated to senior security professional within the organization, but it is also being controlled by the senior manager. Now next, one more thing we have about it, senior manager are ultimately responsible for security and they rarely implement security solution. So as I was telling you, the solution will be given by somebody else who is IT expert. The solution will be given or maintained by somebody else, but ultimately who is responsible for the security is, it is senior manager. They will be taking the final decision. Now next role we have, that is security professional. And obviously if you are doing this particular course of CISSP, you are going to act as a senior professional, security professional for any of the organization. So what will be your job responsibility if you are at a top level? What are the job, what are the policy or what are the condition you supposed to implement or you will be having as a job description for you? So let's have a look on it. Very first thing about security professional, when we talk about either it is a security professional or either you are calling them infosec officer or either you are talking about an entire team which is known as computer incident response team, CIRT, they all are having some specific assigned role to train an experiment network system and security engineer. You can be any individual, you can be a group of this security engineer, it can be a group of network administrator. So they will be actually responsible for following the directive mandated by the senior management. Whatever the final decision will be taken by senior management, you will be the one who will be making sure that it gets properly implemented and you are going to fulfill all the criteria. Another responsibility you have that you will be having a functional responsibility for security, including writing the security policy and implementing. So as I told you, senior manager just can be maybe like a business minded person, but not from IT department, not from the IT background. So they will be just taking the final decision, but who will be making the policy, who will be implementing in the organization, that is going to be done by the security professional. One more point about security professional are, they are not decision maker, because decision will be taken by senior management, but they are implementers. First, they propose the policy. If senior management accept the policy, they will be implementing it back. So all the decision must be left to the senior manager. You can only suggest them what should be done, and if they agree, you are going to implement it. Now the next job we can have, that is of data owner. When we talk about data owner also, this role is assigned to a person who is responsible for classifying information. Where it's supposed to be, how it's supposed to be protected, which particular department should have access, which kind of person should not have access, that will be decided by the data owner. So data owner is also something similar like a management level person. So when we talk about one more thing about data owner is typically a high level manager who is ultimately responsible for data protection. One more information about data owner, that data owner usually delegates the responsibility of the actual data management task to the data custodian. So we are going to talk about data custodian. So data custodian will be working on the guideline which will be given by the data owner, that who will be having what kind of rights, that will be decided by data owner, and data custodian will be following the same policy and rules there. So basically, data owner is nothing else. It is the person who is classifying your information. And in the last video, I have already talked about the data classification. So on the basis of that, data owner can classify the data, which data is very highly top secure, top secret, or which one is having less security. Now the next thing comes, that is data custodian. When we talk about data custodian, it is a role which is assigned to a user who is responsible for the task of implementing the prescribed protection defined by the security policy or by the senior management. So whatever senior manager or security professionals has decided, or even the data owner is telling him to implement, on the basis of that, actually at the ground level, data custodian is the guy who is implementing the policy, who is putting those all functions there. Like if any employee or any data owner comes and say that I want to have this particular data to be accessed only by account department, not by anybody else, so who will be implementing the policy actually, on the basis of the user, on the basis of the group, on the basis of data storage location, that will be done by the data custodian. Another point about data custodian is they perform all activity necessary to provide CIA triad, means confidentiality, integrity and availability. To maintain these three things, confidentiality, integrity and availability, whatever required are, they are going to do it. They are going to fulfill the requirement and responsibility delegated from upper management. Whatever the upper management level has made the policy, he will be just following the policy. They will just get a guideline that this is what policy we have, and just you have to implement, that's it. They are not going to give their own any policy statement or something. They will be just getting a guideline and they have to follow the guideline, that's it. So these activity can include performing and testing like a backups, validating data integrity, deploying security solution, managing data storage based on classification. So these all tasks will be done by actually data custodian. Now the next role comes, that is user, means all the other employee who will be using the resources, who will be accessing those resources. So users means what? The user is nothing else, it's an end user or operator which is assigned to any person who has access to the secured system. Maybe any user who comes to your office and use company computer or company resources, company data, company server, those all are user. So an user access is tied to their work task and are limited, so they have only enough access to perform the task necessary for their job procedure. So whatever data custodian has given the rights, on the basis of that only user will have the access or deny permission on the resources. He will not be deciding or changing any policy. He will not be making any policy. He will not be decision maker. Everything will be done by else. He is just a user who will be accessing the resource on the basis of whatever rights he has or she has. Next comes, that is auditor. Auditor can be anybody. Auditor can be already inside employee of the company, or it can be a third person also. So when we talk about auditor roles and responsibility, an auditor is responsible for reviewing and verifying that the security policy is properly implemented and derived security solutions are adequate. So meaning that once already policy has been made, when already security professional has made the policy, senior manager has approved it, data custodian has implemented it, and users are using it, then auditor comes and just verify everything, how well it is going, how the CIA is being maintained, how the policy is working there. So that is what the task of auditor is. The auditor role may be assigned to a security professional itself, or maybe a trained user. That will be again decided by the senior managers. So they will decide who will be acting as an auditor, what rights he will be having, and then he will be going through all the policies, he will be checking, verifying them, and he will be making a report also. Another thing is, the auditor produce a compliance and effective report so that it will have all information related to the policy, and that particular report will be reviewed by the senior manager, so that at the end they will be able to come to know that whatever we discussed before, whatever policy we have decided, either it is 100% working or not, or if there is some kind of glitch, if there is some kind of problems, how we can solve it, or maybe if there is any kind of loophole in our policy, what changes are needed to be done there. Another thing is, it also issues discovered through these reports are transformed into the new directive. So whatever one auditing report comes, on the basis of that, next financial year or maybe next year, the policy can be changed on the basis of that. So that was all about the auditor. It can be the auditor can be assigned by the senior manager to any security professional or maybe a data custodian also. Now we are going to talk about security control frameworks. So when we talk about security control frameworks, what does it mean? What kind of image comes in our mind? Generally, crafting a security instance for an organization often involves a lot more than just writing down a few lofty ideals. So in most cases, a significant amount of planning goes into developing a solid security policy. And many Dilbert's fans may recognize the seemingly absurd concept of holding a meeting to plan a meeting for future meeting. But it turns out that planning for security must start with planning to plan, then move into the planning for a standard and compliance, and finally move into the actual plan, development and design. So to fulfill this all things, we generally go through any predefined security control frameworks. And when we talk about those, one of the more widely used security control framework is known as Control Objective for Information and Related Technology. In short name, it is called as a COBIT. We call it COBIT. So this COBIT means Control Objective for Information and Related Technology. And this is one of the most common type of control frameworks we have. So when we talk about it, COBIT is a documented set of best IT security practices crafted by the ISACA, which is full name is Information Systems Audit and Control Association. So they have crafted it, they have made a document which name is COBIT, and it is a proper set for best IT security practices. So it is not only being used by the organization, it is also being used by the auditor also when they come to do the any kind of auditing for the company. So it prescribes goal and requirement for security control. Any organization, those who are going through the COBIT rules, the set of best IT security practices, it is going to help them to have the goal and requirement for security control, and also encourage the mapping of IT security ideals to business objective. Now to have this COBIT, it works on actually five key principles, and those five key principles are: first principle is meeting a stakeholder needs, what your stakeholder needs is. Then second is covering the enterprise end to end. Third comes that applying a single integrated framework. Fourth principle comes that is enabling a holistic approach. And the fifth final one comes that separating governance from management. So these are some of the five major principles of COBIT are, and on the basis of that, COBIT operates, COBIT works. So when you go through the entire detail about it, you may just go to the website, which is called as a ISACA. So you can visit the website of www.isaca.org. You will be getting a complete detail of it. You will be getting a complete list of all the procedure and everything. Or you can even, if you want a general overview, you can go to the Wikipedia and you can read about COBIT there also. Now, COBIT, as I told you, that it is used not only to plan the IT security for an organization, but it is also being used as a guideline for the auditors. So most of the auditor generally, they follow the steps of COBIT. COBIT is a widely recognized and respected security control firm. There are very many others also, like if I try to list here, so there are some others such as OSSTMM, which is known as Open Source Security Testing Methodology Manual. Then you can also use maybe ISO or a stroke IEC 27002, which is replaced ISO 17799. These are some of the again security control frameworks which is being used by the organization. So an international standard that can be the basis of implementing organizational security and related management practices, you can find from there. Plus we have some other also, such as like ITIL, Information Technology Infrastructure Library. It is initially crafted by actually British government, but now it is being used by others as well. And ITIL is a set of recommended best practices for core IT security and operational process, and is often used as a starting point for the crafting of a customized IT security solution. So these are some of the others different standard for and guideline for the IT security. But as I told you, one of the most common are COBIT. Now the last slide, I would like to talk a bit about due care and due diligence. These are the two terms which is actually. So why is planning to plan security so important? Because one reason is the requirement of due care and due diligence. Due care is nothing else, actually it is using reasonable care to protect the interest of an organization. Where if we talk about due diligence, it is actually nothing else, it is a practicing the activity that maintain the due care efforts. So this is what the basic two terms are, due care and due diligence. When we talk about it, maybe let me take one example here. So for example, due care is developing a formalized security structure containing a security policy, standards, baseline, guidelines and procedure. Where when we talk about due diligence, it is continued application of this security structure into the IT infrastructure of an organization. So when we talk about today business environment, precedence is mandatory, and showing due care and due diligence is the only way to disprove negligence or in any occurrence of loss, and senior management must show due care and due diligence to reduce their capability and liability when a loss occurs. So that's why these two terms are very important. As a security professional, you must be knowing about it and you must be having awareness about it. So that was all about in this video, where we have talked about what are the different roles and responsibilities are when we talk about in any organization. So we talked about organization roles and responsibility. Then we also talked in this video about security control frameworks, as well as we ended with the due care and due diligence. So I hope this video was informative for you all, and I would like to thank you for watching.